Good morning, children. Welcome back. Children, in the previous video, we started with the new chapter, Women, Caste and Reforms. We have already discussed that in the 18th and 19th centuries, many social evils were present in our Indian society, like Sati Pratha, female feticide, Parda system, not sending girls to school, polygamy and many more. We also discussed about many social reformers like Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, Swami Dayanand Saraswati, Veer Salingam, Pandita Ramabai, Tarabai Shinde. All these social reformers, they worked for the upliftment of women in our society. Today we will proceed further and we will discuss about some more social reformers who worked in the areas where people had to face caste discrimination. So, let us start. The reformers of the period criticized caste inequalities. Raja Ram Mohan Roy realized that the reform of the Indian society had to be preceded by the reform in Hinduism itself. He believed that Hinduism should be free from the control of the Brahmanas, okay, who opposed progress and were responsible for the oppression of the lower caste. Thus, he took up the task of translating the Hindu scriptures into Bengali. Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar and Swami Vivekananda also worked for the caste reforms. Swami Vivekananda believed that caste was a social system and not a religious institution. The religious texts did not talk of caste. What made a person supreme was not his caste but his inherent qualities. Vivekananda also criticized the practice of untouchability. He said that Hindu religious texts did not advocate untouchability. Apart from these reformers, there were also others who questioned the injustices of the caste social order. During the course of the 19th century, Christian missionaries began setting up schools for tribal groups and lower caste children. These children were thus equipped with some resources to make their way into the changing world. At the same time, the poor began leaving their villages to look for jobs that were opening up in the cities. There was work in the factories that were coming up and jobs in municipalities. Some also went to work in plantations in Assam, Mauritius, Trinidad and Indonesia. Work in the new location was often very hard, but the poor, the people from the lower caste, saw this as an opportunity to get away from the oppressive hold that the upper caste landowners exercised over their lives and the daily humiliation they suffered. Gradually, by the second half of the 19th century, people from within the lower caste began organizing movement against caste discrimination and demanded social equality and justice. The Satnami movement in central India, founded by a leader named Ghasi Das, who came from a low caste, worked among the leather workers and organized a movement to improve their social status. In eastern Bengal, Haridas Thakur's Matua sect worked among the low caste Chandala cultivators. In present-day Kerala, Sri Narayan Guru proclaimed the ideals of unity for his people. He advocated equality of all within a single sect or caste. He inspired all of them to have faith in one guru alone, that is, he himself. One of the most vocal amongst the low caste leaders was Jyotirao Phule. Born in 1827, he studied in schools set up by Christian missionaries. On growing up, he developed his own ideas about the injustices of caste society. He set out to attack the Brahmins' claim that they were superior to others since they were Aryans.
Foulé argued that the Aryans were foreigners who came from outside the subcontinent and defeated and subjugated the true children of the country, those who had lived here from before the coming of the Aryans. As the Aryans established their dominance, they began looking at the defeated population as inferior. In 1873, Foulé wrote a book named Gulamgiri, meaning slavery. Ambedkar was born into a Meher family. As a child, he experienced what caste prejudice meant in everyday life. In school, he was forced to sit outside the classroom on the ground and was not allowed to drink water from the taps that upper caste children used. After finishing school, he got a fellowship to go to the US for higher studies. On his return to India in 1919, he wrote extensively about upper caste power in contemporary society. In 1927, Ambedkar started a temple entry movement in which his Meher caste followers participated. Brahmin priests were outraged when the Dalit used water from the temple tank. Ambedkar led three such movements for temple entry between 1927 and 1935. His aim was to make everyone see the power and caste prejudice within the society. In the early 20th century, the non-Brahmin movement started. The initiative came from those non-Brahmin caste that had acquired access to education, wealth and influence. E.V. Ramaswamy Naikar, or Periyar as he was called, came from a middle class family. Interestingly, he had been an ascetic in his early life and had studied Sanskrit scriptures carefully. Later, he became a member of the Congress only to leave it in disgust when he found that at a feast organized by the nationalists, seating arrangements followed caste distinction. Periyar founded the self-respect movement. He argued that untouchables were the true upholders of the original Tamil and Dravidian culture, which had been subjugated by the Brahmins. Periyar was an outspoken critic of Hindu scriptures, especially the codes of Manu, the ancient lawgiver, and the Bhagavad Gita and the Ramayana. He said that these texts had been used to establish the authority of the Brahmin over the lower caste and the domination of man over woman. Debates and struggle over caste continued beyond the colonial period and are still going on in our own times. That's the end of the chapter, children. Goodbye.